What's up, ladies and gents? Welcome back to Red Band Cast Channel. Hope you guys have been having a good time. This is going to be, of course, the very first Hellraiser review. This is just a little bit of a comment on the quality. I know the quality is probably not great. I'm using an app called Screencast-O-Matic. It's doing the best that it can. I wish I could do this a better way. But for some reason, my phone is not letting me upload anything longer than 4 minutes. And if you saw my first video, the Hobbit video, then it's probably going to be something like that if I try to upload it. You know, cuts me off halfway through my review, and I don't want to do that. And I don't want to go down to reviews in under a few. Well, like 8 minutes or something like that. I don't want to go to that. So, this is what I'm going to be doing from now on, probably. Screencast-O-Matic. So, best I can do. So, for now, until I figure out a better way. Hellraiser. Directed by Clive Barker, 1987. This is the original of the series. And let me go ahead and say one thing about Hellraiser before I actually start talking about the movie. I personally have never been a huge Hellraiser fan, but for some reason I got a hankering to watch Part 5 recently, which I think is called Inferno. And I don't really know why I got this idea to watch Inferno, but I really wanted to, and just decided to go ahead and give it a try. So, watched maybe half of Inferno, and I was like, you know what, this is actually really good. Maybe I'll go back and watch some of these. So I decided, of course, to go ahead and watch them, and that is, of course, why we're doing this right now. So, to get into the actual Hellraiser movie, the plot is not simple at all. It is, to get it down to its most basic parts, it's a guy opens up a puzzle box, his family gets involved, and this puzzle box has evil creatures within it. It's sort of the portal to a different world of untold and forbidden pleasures, extremes of pain and pleasure in equal measure. So that's sort of the idea, but his family gets sucked into this as well. And they have to fight against even this guy who has just always been a horrible person anyway. And, of course, the creatures called the Cenobites, who are led by Pinhead. Now, I'm going to try not to compare this to the Hellbound Heart, because the Hellbound Heart is certainly a very different book than this movie. It's a very different kind of feel. Also, I did not watch this particular edition, the Midnight Madness series. Just couldn't really get that, really. What I mean by that is the Midnight Madness series, I'm very happy they put out the films that they did in this DVD series. I'm glad to have this DVD in my collection. Picture quality is awful. So I tried Netflix. Picture quality is still not that great. But it's certainly better on Netflix than it was in this. So, let's get that out of the way. So, as far as the actual movie goes, I think that it is a movie that is not very good, but with a bunch of very good moments. I think the movie just barely sort of holds together. It has a mixture of really lowbrow dialogue with highfalutin ideas and some really high-flown dialogue by the Cenobites, mainly Pinhead, played by Doug Bradley. It's got some great acting in it. It's got some bad acting in it. I believe the character of Larry is pretty badly acted. Don't really like the way that he's portrayed here. But I do sort of feel, I still have a little bit of sympathy towards him. I think that at least that works as far as what they're trying to get with that. But, in any case, like I said, good acting. It's got a bunch of good moments, One of those good moments I would probably have to say is the moments with the Cenobites. When you have Pinhead, when you have Chatterer, when you have the female Cenobite, I can't remember her name, but when you have those characters and stuff, it really comes together well. The acting is perfect for that. The camera work is always great with them. The way that it looks is just fantastic. It always turns this sort of weird, sickly kind of blue, which is just wonderful. And, you know, it's just really, really well done. I think most of the scenes with Julia and Frank together are really good. I think that the tension between them is great. I think Claire, I can't remember her last name, but Claire something, who plays Julia, is actually really, really good in that role. I think it's really fantastic what she does. She's creepy. She sort of goes back and forth between her moral self and her self that really just wants pleasure. That of course is sort of the reason that she's trying to help Frank. I love the social commentary of the film, that people only seek towards the pleasure that they want, and that will ultimately lead to death and damnation and stuff like that. I love that social commentary there. I think Clive Barker, though he professes himself to be somewhere between a Christian and a non-Christian, a Christian and an anti-Christian, it's kind of obvious that he does have a certain Christian influence. I think that that is shown, at least in this film. I haven't seen any other Clive Barker directed films. I'm hoping to see Nightbreed soon, maybe do a review of that, but certainly in the book and the movie, you get both of those parts. Of course, also, he loves to talk about sexuality. And in here, it's very frank, no pun intended, about sort of the evils and the goods of sexuality. The good sexuality is upheld, the bad is sort of defamed. I think it's a very clear right and wrong kind of movie, surprisingly, although it does blur the lines between those ideas of pleasure and pain. I think right and wrong are very clearly defined here. I also really like the way that that Julia, well not Julia, that Kirstie is played. I really like her character. I think she's a great sort of final girl type character. As far as negatives to the movie though, as I said, there are a number of good sequences in the movie, and they're very well-filmed sequences, well-plotted-out sequences, such as, you know, the Cenobites showing up. Anytime that you see Frank transforming into something different, stuff like that. But there are also a number of really, really bad sequences. The acting is so mixed. I've talked about pretty much all the actors that are good. The Cenobites, Julia, occasionally Frank will be good, occasionally he will be bad. Kirstie is almost always good. Her boyfriend is such a dullard, and he's not good in any way. I think he does have that great iconic moment where he sticks the cigarette into his mouth and brings it back out and takes another puff on it. That's really good. However, it just doesn't seem like he has any other moment besides that where he really shines. I don't think there are many moments where he does shine, actually. He's just not very good. He's a little bit too wooden. Larry is played really woodenly as well. I love the actor. I can't remember his name, but I do remember him from Dirty Harry. He was the Scorpio killer there. And he was fantastic there. I really love his character. It's, well, not love, but you understand. It's very... it's a very good character, very well acted. However, I don't think that he does that well here. I think he really ends up sort of bringing the movie down in the way that he's acting. It's just not It's not that great. So, besides that, there are just other moments where it's entirely not plotted out well. I think that entire thing in the hospital, besides the Cenobites showing up, is just not well done. It's so flimsily held together, those scenes. They're just not very good. They're not well acted. It just doesn't work. Let's see. I like it when the Cenobites initially show up, but I really don't care much for the actor playing Frank at that point. He looks the part, but the fact that his voice was entirely dubbed, and he has some moments where they have close-ups that are just not effective. The way his face, his expressions are not that great. Anytime that we see that particular version of Frank. Frank without his skin is much better acted than Frank with it on, surprisingly. The fact that the engineer just isn't shown hardly at all, and it's just, whenever he does show up, it's so cheesy. The monster with the horrible special effects. Some of the special effects are great in the movie, other special effects are horrible. That whole sex sequence between Julia and Frank near sort of the 15-20 minute mark of the movie, it sort of goes back and forth for me as to whether I think it was actually needed, whether they actually had to show what they showed, or whether they could have just implied it. I do like the way that it is intercut with Larry cutting his hand. That really makes you squirm. I like that part of it. But there are just a lot of back and forth moments, I think, with that movie. It's just not fantastic. To be honest, I feel like I may remember liking Hellraiser 3 the most out of the entire series. And I feel like I may have thought at least Part 2 was my second favorite. But I'll find that out later. As I said, there are still great merits to this movie, but there are also great detractors. So I'm going to have to give it probably about a 2.5 out of 5 for Clive Barker's Hellraiser from 1987. Not quite the classic that I think most people have made it out to be. In any case, though, I really did half enjoy it. And I really did enjoy making this video. So I hope you guys really enjoyed the review. I hope you come back for the next reviews. I hope that my negativity with the first movie doesn't affect the way that you view my next reviews, because I do really like the book thus far. I'm about 20 pages from finishing it, so that should probably be finished today, if not tomorrow. If I get the time to do a review of it today, I will. If I get the time to finish it today, I will. But in any case, I will probably be reviewing next either Hellraiser 2, Hellbound, or I will be reviewing The Hellbound Heart. It all really depends on my schedule. So, ladies and gents, thank you very, very much for watching my review of Hellraiser. Tell me about your opinions of Hellraiser in the comments section below. Please like and subscribe, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day. Thanks so much. Peace.